I greet you this morning in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, and blessings to you as we worship again this Sunday in God's house. And wherever you are joining us today, we thank you. And I just want to welcome everybody here on St. Thomas who's not in the sanctuary, but who's home and watching and worshiping with us. And especially I want to say good morning to Jason all the way on the north side. Good morning, Jason. And not only here in the Virgin Islands, but throughout the country and the world. Welcome, Jamie from Detroit. Welcome to the Doblers in Holland, Michigan. Welcome to Rich in Colorado. Welcome to Frank and Janine in Maitland, Florida. Welcome to the Mannings all the way over in the Netherlands, to Lucy in San Juan, Puerto Rico, and to Elizabeth in the Dominican Republic, and all the places that we are gathering together this morning. And all the Dominican Republic, where 22 of us were supposed to be this past week. Traditionally, this would be our mission trip Sunday. And today, I'm happy to say that we are keeping that tradition alive. Let our worship today be a celebration of those youth who are a reminder to us of, you know, one of the great things about this church that we get to go every year. And let our worship be in a reminder to continue to go out into this world and to share the love of Christ. I want to say a special thank you to Bonham Geller. He's the ninth grader from Antilles, one of our XYG members who just played that beautiful guitar prelude. Thank you, Bonham. As those of you who watched the news heard this week, Governor Brian updated us on the state of the territory and the coronavirus, and he began a staged opening, or we are starting that this week. Consistory is going to meet on Tuesday to consider what that means for us and our response for moving forward. And so you expect an update or a letter later this week from me, and we'll try to keep everybody up to speed on what we're doing. And I ask you to pray for discernment as we do that, as a church and as a community and all of us throughout this pandemic. And on a sad note, I do want to mention and ask for your prayers. Monday, we lost a very dedicated RCA pastor, scholar, denominational staff member, seminary president, and a friend to COVID-19. Reverend Greg Allen Mast passed away on Monday. He was the president of New Brunswick Theological Seminary. Some of you may remember Reverend Mast. He visited us in 2012. And preached from this pulpit here. And so I just extend prayers and condolences to the Mast family and to the Reformed Church in America family and this loss. We gather today, though, to focus on life, the life of Jesus Christ, our Lord. We will gather around this table during the service together to celebrate communion with the living Christ. I invite you to make preparations at home with elements so that we can eat and drink together. So now let us worship God, our Creator. Our help is in the name of the Lord, who made heaven and earth. Amen. Let us pray. Holy God, we gather to celebrate our generous, reviving, and gracious God. And we come to give our thanks for the good news that you, Lord, care for each and every one of us. We come to give our thanks that you are a God who forgives and forgets our sin. And so, steadfast God, we gather to remember and to give thanks for your unfailing love and your blessings that you so graciously pour out over us. We come to give thanks that you, who we worship through song and prayer and fellowship, you show us your unfailing love. Accept the praises, Lord, of your people, of our thankful hearts. In Jesus' name, amen. So we sing now one of our favorite mission trip songs and a tribute this morning to the late, great Bill Withers, Lean on Me. Mm-hmm.
Times in our lives, we all have pain. We all have sorrow. But if we are wise, we know that there's always tomorrow. Lean on me when you're not strong, and I'll be your friend. I'll help you carry on, for it won't be long till I'm gonna need somebody to lean on. Please swallow your pride if I have things you need to borrow, for no one can your needs that you don't let show. Lean on me when you're not strong, and I'll be your friend. I'll help you carry on, for it won't be long till I'm gonna need somebody to. I just might have a problem that you'll understand. We all need somebody to lean on. If there is a load that you have to bear, that you can't carry, oh, I'm right up the road, and I'll share your load. Out of dust.
So good to be here. It's a beautiful night.
So, Seth, what? Can you tell us where we're going?
We are going to La Iglesia, which means the church.
Nice.
Stay where it's safer. Claim faith but waver. Is this how we're really meant to live? We pray but never move. We say but never do.
I'd like to offer a brief message today on Paul's letter to the Colossians chapter 2, verses 6 to 7. Paul is writing this letter, and he opens the letter by saying, Paul, an apostle of Christ Jesus, by the will of God, and Timothy, our brother, to the saints and faithful brothers and sisters in Christ in Colossae. Grace to you and peace from God our Father. I always feel like Paul could have been writing that to the St. Thomas Reformed Church, to the saints and faithful brothers and sisters who are part of this congregation. He goes on to say two short verses this morning. As you therefore have received Christ Jesus the Lord, continue to live your lives in him, rooted and built up in him, and established in the faith, just as you were taught, abounding in thanksgiving. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. I know that I really shouldn't make a habit of using my own children in sermon illustrations every week, but here goes. I was listening to my four-year-old daughter talk, and it occurred to me this week that she is saying words and phrases that, for me as a child growing up in upstate New York, I never even knew existed, like Johnny Cake. I guarantee you that at the age of four, I had never once uttered the words together, Johnny Cake. My brother's name was John, so I know I said Johnny when I wanted to get under his skin. And you remember that, you know, Johnny, 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 whoops, Johnny, whoops, Johnny, 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 Johnny. And I know what cake was because I had a birthday every year, but I can guarantee you that I never said Johnny Cake together. It didn't, in fact, become part of my regular vocabulary until I moved here to St. Thomas about 14 years ago. And I have to admit, it's probably one of the things that I miss most about Carnival this year. And of course, a word that none of us knew existed until this year, coronavirus. We've never uttered that word till this year. I wish it was a word that we never knew. I wish. Wishing means things are not as you hoped they would be. If you tuned in last week, you heard me speak about the disappointments that we live with. We had hoped, the disciples said, on the road to Emmaus, to the living Christ. And I'm going to preface what I'm about to say with saying it's admittedly difficult to talk about this disappointment as I know that so many other people are dealing with huge disappointments like illness and death and separation from loved ones and other large-scale losses. But it is very disappointing not to have traveled to the Dominican Republic with our XYG mission group this year. I wish that we were in Jarabacoa, the Dominican Republic. The same place that you just saw on the video, the same place where we were last year, where we have forged wonderful relationships with wonderfully faithful people over the past 20 plus years. But this year, more than any other, the theme of our trip, which we have a different theme every year, was coincidentally so very relevant and so simply perfect. Give thanks. XYG Mission Trip 2020, give thanks. Like Paul said to the church in Colossae, and I want to say again, I want to say this particularly to our youth who were going on this trip. As you therefore have received Christ Jesus the Lord, continue to live your lives in him, rooted and built up in him, established in the faith just as you were taught, abounding in thanksgiving. Give thanks. I want to give thanks to this church, the St. Thomas Reformed Church, and to this whole island community. So many of you have supported these youth throughout this past year and previous years. I want to give thanks for the group of high school students and our three adult leaders who prepared all year long. We helped cleanup beaches, who served our royal seniors, who helped with East's recycling efforts, who provided food and fellowship to our own church family each month. And they've done it all, they did it all, while having lots of fun. I want to particularly give thanks for our two seniors, Haley Jennings and Annika Hanfeld, both of whom I know are disappointed to having to miss their last XYG mission trip, but both of whom were happy to share some of their past experiences with us now.
Good morning, everyone. I miss seeing everyone in church. Hopefully we'll be together soon. For anyone who doesn't know me, my name is Annika Hanfeld. I'm a senior at Antilles School, and I will be attending Boston University in the fall. I have really grown up in this church, and I always look forward to hearing the amazing experiences and stories of those who left to help others for mission trip. I love seeing the bond between XYGers when they returned, how they're still laughing together about inside jokes, how they treated each other like family. I knew from early on these mission trips are really special and unique. So when I left for Puerto Rico my first year, I was ecstatic. I still remember the Ponce community embracing us with open arms when we arrived. I remember playing with the children and the adults helping us paint their homes because they were so touched that we were there to assist them. I remember how caring and openly loving they were, and it was such an eye-opening experience for me because I realized then there that genuine happiness doesn't come from the latest iPhone, an expensive car, a big house. It really comes from the people you love and cherish. Your friends and family, the people you truly care about, are always going to be way more important than anything money can buy. And I was proven that again during our next mission trip, when we returned to Ponce after Hurricanes Irma Maria. Even though they had suffered the destruction of their church and other meaningful buildings, they were still so faithful in God and each other, and again treated us with so much love and very delicious food, might I add. My next and unfortunately last mission trip occurred in Jarabacoa in the Dominican Republic, where we helped the community there expand their local school and spent quality time playing with the kids that attended there. I have so many memories of running around, playing soccer, tag, freeze tag, like any game you can think of, we played it with the kids. My last favorite part of mission trips was at the end of the day, when we were all exhausted from working and playing and helping the communities out. We was in a circle and sang songs like Beautiful Things and Give Me Jesus while Jeff played the guitar. These memories, along with the values and lessons I learned from these trips, will always be with me beyond high school, beyond college, beyond my career. And I will always be forever grateful for this experience, this opportunity to go out and help others. For anyone who's considering joining XYG, please do so. It will change your life and give you so much perspective. A major thank you to Pastor Jeff, Bob and Camille, Kathy, Seth, and Felice. I know some of you aren't with us right now, but thank you so, so much. And as well, a major thank you to the entire congregation for supporting us to the fullest. It truly means so much. And I've learned so much, and I'm so grateful. So thank you, thank you, thank you to everyone. And I hope everyone is staying safe and healthy. And hopefully we'll see everyone soon. Bye.
Good morning, congregation. As you know, of our unfortunate circumstances, this year's XYG team is not able to travel and help others who need it. This year is unfortunately my last year as part of the youth group, and even though we can't travel this year, I have made so many memories with previous and current members of youth group members, and as well as the relationships we formed in communities in Ponte, Puerto Rico, y Jarabacoa, La República Dominicana. My first two mission trips were before and after Irma Maria, the two Category 5 hurricanes, devastated the Caribbean. We went to the same little community named Mercedito in Ponce, Puerto Rico, both times, before and after. The work we did before and after the hurricanes were completely different experiences. before we were painting and renovating houses, but after we were helping with the demolition of the little church they all cherished. The demolition was necessary because it withheld too much damage to just repair, so it needed to start a new slate. Even though the people of the little community were facing tough times, they always had smiles on their faces and found ways to have fun, such as, if you remember the Little Rock game from Shaw, when he was playing with one of the kids in the community, the game essentially was guessing which hand the rock was in behind the person's back. They played this game for like a solid 15 minutes and they would not stop laughing throughout the entire time. These trips showed me to never take anything for granted and to find positive ways to look at things, no matter how bad the situation is. Last year in Jarabacoa, we cleaned up around the river, helped build part of a school, also played with the kids at the school and at the orphanage, and even had a chance to be guests at some of the locals' house for dinner. Playing with the kids always got intense, no matter at the orphanage or the school. We were all like the new toys they wanted to play with, and we never got a chance to take a break. Either you were at Caballito, which was like carrying a person on your back, like horseback, or you got chased down until you were forced to play one of the other games like soccer. Juliana is one of the kids from the orphanage who showed me around the place and showed me where all the good mangoes were. But of course, before she was nice to me, she had to chase me down with all of her friends, and we're playing around, throwing mud, just kid stuff. Like, but it was okay because she showed me where the mangoes were. I enjoyed every experience I've had during these mission trips, and it's all thanks to Pastor Jeff, the leaders, XYG members, and of course, you, the congregation, all the endless support that you give. And thank you guys, thank all of you so much, and this wouldn't be possible without every single one of you. Have a blessed day.
Bye. Yes, we abound in thanksgiving. And so now let us give thanks with our offerings as we prepare to come around this table, this holy supper that we are about to receive, to break bread with the risen Christ. I invite you now to give your gifts, your tithes and your offerings, and join us as we sing together our mission trip song for this year, I Will Offer Up My Life. I will offer up my life in spirit and truth, pouring out the oil of love as my worship to you. Surrender, I must give my every part. Lord, receive the sacrifice of a broken heart. Jesus, what can I give?
Savior, what can be said? Buenas tardes para cada uno de ustedes. Doy gracias a Dios por la vida de cada uno. Le amamos de aquí, de República Dominicana. En estos momentos quiero hacer una pequeña oración por cada uno de ustedes y que Dios sea su protector en todo esto que estamos pasando. Así que, Padre, en nombre de Jesús, te doy gracias. Te pido que sea tu Dios con el Pastor Jeff y con cada persona de ese lugar, de la iglesia, los jóvenes, Señor, los adultos. Señor, para que tú te manifiestes sobre ellos, para que no haya ninguna enfermedad sobre ellos, Señor, y que este virus sea esparcido en el aire y que no pueda llegar a ninguno de su familia, Padre amado. Por eso te digo, Padre, tú que estás en los cielos, tú que eres nuestro poder, Señor, nuestra confianza, te pido que en el nombre de Jesús tú seas protegiéndolo. Amén y amén.
And thank you to our brother Rudy there in Jarabacoa for that prayer, and our prayers are with you and your family and that entire community. May God bless you, and we will see you next year. Let's together now use the words of the Apostles' Creed and state our faith together. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell, and the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth in the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Beloved in the Lord Jesus, the meal which we are about to celebrate is a feast of remembrance, communion, and hope. We come to remember that Jesus was sent into the world to assume our flesh and blood, to become God with us, that we might be redeemed. We come to have communion with this same Christ, who has promised to be with us even to the end of the world. We come in hope, believing that this bread and this cup are a pledge and a foretaste of a new heaven and a new earth where we shall behold God. Jesus said, "I was hungry and you gave me food.
I was thirsty and you gave me drink.
Here is the bread of life given for us.
Let all who hunger come and eat.
Here is the fruit of the vine poured out for us.
Let all who thirst come and drink.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
Holy and right it is to give thanks and praise at all times and in all places, O God, our Creator, source of all life and goodness. You created heaven with all its hosts and the earth with all its plenty, and you preserve us by your providence. With your whole church on earth and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your glory. Most righteous God, we remember in this meal the perfect sacrifice offered once on the cross by our Lord Jesus Christ for the sin of the whole world. United with Christ in his suffering, strengthened by the Holy Spirit, trusting in the power of God to triumph over evil, we wait in joyful hope for the fullness of God's reign. Send your Holy Spirit upon us, we pray, that the bread which we break and the cup which we bless may be to us the communion of the body and blood of Christ. And grant that being joined together in him, we may attain to the unity of the faith and grow up in all things into Christ our Lord. And as this grain has been gathered from many fields into one loaf, and these grapes from many hills into one cup, grant, O Lord, that your whole church may soon be gathered from the ends of the earth into your kingdom. Even so, come, Lord Jesus. On the night in which Jesus was betrayed, he took bread, and after giving thanks, he broke it. He gave it to his disciples, and he said, "This is my body, which is broken for you. Whenever you eat this bread, remember me." In the same manner also, he took the cup and he blessed it. He gave it to them. He said, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Whenever you drink from this cup, remember me." The bread which we break is the communion of the body of Christ. The cup of blessing which we bless is the communion of the blood of Christ. I invite you now to partake, take bread, take your cup, and together we will eat together. Brothers and sisters, Since the Lord has now fed us at his table, let us praise God's holy name with heartfelt thanksgiving. Bless the Lord, O my soul.
And all that is within me, bless his holy name.
Bless the Lord, O my soul.
And do not forget all his benefits.
Who forgives all your iniquity.
Who heals all your diseases.
Who redeems your life from the pit.
Who crowns you with steadfast love and mercy.
The Lord is merciful and gracious.
Slow to anger and abounding in steadfast love.
He does not deal with us according to our sins.
Nor repay us according to our iniquities.
For as the heavens are high above the earth,
so great is his steadfast love toward those who fear him.
As far as the east is from the west,
so far does he remove our transgressions from us.
As a father has compassion for his children,
so the Lord has compassion for those who fear him.
Who did not spare his own son, but gave him up for us all, and who will also give us all things in with him.
Therefore shall my mouth and heart show forth the praise of the Lord
from this time forth and forevermore.
Amen.
I invite you to join hands with whoever you are with, and together we'll end this service with the singing of the Lord's Prayer. Jesus Christ, fully embraced by the love of God and encouraged by the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, let us always and forever give thanks. Amen. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you for your support.
Much appreciated.
Thank you.